Thomas Hardy was born in this cottage. His family was very poor. His father was a stonemason, and neither of his parents were particularly well educated. His mother, however, was widely read and tutored Hardy at home. Hardy was still living in his cottage when he wrote Under the Greenwood Tree.
The cottage was built by Hardy's grandfather and still looks much as it did during Hardy's lifetime. As a child, Hardy attended the local school. However, his family lacked the money then for university, so Hardy was apprenticed to an architect. He later went to London to continue his study of architecture, but didn't like London and returned to Dorset to devote himself to writing. While working on an architectural job, he met and fell in love with Emma Lavinia Gifford, whom he married in 1874. In 1885, Hardy designed and built this house, known as Maxgate, and lived here until his death. Although Hardy's marriage wasn't a particularly happy one and they became estranged, when Emma Hardy died in 1912, Hardy was deeply affected by her death, made a trip to visit the place they had met, and wrote about the experience in poems 1912-1913. Only a year later, Hardy married his secretary, who was nearly 40 years younger than he. While living at Maxgate, Hardy wrote some of his best-known novels, such as Tess of the D'Urbervilles and Jude the Obscure. He also wrote many of his poems here. Many literary greats visited Hardy at Maxgate, including T.E. Lawrence, George Bernard Shaw, Virginia Woolf, and even the Prince of Wales, the future Edward VIII. Hardy died at Maxgate in 1928. His heart was buried with his first wife, and his ashes were buried in Poets' Corner at Westminster Abbey.